Police say that he knew her, killed her, and rolled her body up in a carpet before leaving it in her driveway. Today, the man accused in this Punahou Street murder faced a judge for the first time. Thanks for joining us. I'm Kenny Choi in for Paula Akana.
And I'm Yenji Denise. We also learned much more today about how the public played a big role in his arrest. KITV4's Andrew Pereira has more in tonight's top story. Andrew.
Kenny, Yenji, police say tips from the public helped them draw an arrow that pointed directly to Vernon Baker.
Vernon Baker's voice could barely be heard Tuesday as he appeared in Honolulu District Court.
Your bail right now is set at $200,000 for all these charges. That will be enough. Thank you.
Baker entered pleas of not guilty to second-degree murder and drug charges, but court documents show he's the prime suspect in the murder of 56-year-old Mary Beth San Juan, a real estate agent and aspiring actress. San Juan's bound and gagged body was found inside a rolled carpet at her Punahou Street home last Tuesday evening by her ex-husband. A day later, San Juan's silver Mercedes-Benz was located near the Kapi'olani Park bandstand. 2 days after her body was found, San Juan's wallet was discovered inside a dumpster at the Waikiki Beachside Hostel. A check of the guest list showed Baker had stayed there. However, the investigation truly caught fire after help from the public.
We had two very critical tips from the public. One helped us to identify the suspect, and the other helped us to recover a very critical piece of evidence.
According to court documents, Honolulu Crime Stoppers received a tip from a witness that spotted a man that looked like Baker going through San Juan's Mercedes on the day her body was found. The Mercedes was parked in San Juan's driveway on Punahou Street, and the witness later identified Baker from a picture on his Facebook page. Police then began watching Baker, and on Saturday saw him leave the hostel on Lemon Road with a backpack and several laptop-type bags. Baker walked to a nearby pavilion on Kalakaua Avenue, where he sat down and spoke to a homeless man in a green shirt.
Police believe Baker then handed San Juan's laptop computer to the homeless man to sell it for cash. That was confirmed later that Saturday afternoon when police dispatch received a call from a woman saying she had recovered San Juan's computer from the homeless man who was offering it for sale.
With all of the evidence closing in around Baker, police followed him to the Ala Moana Shopping Center, where he was arrested for San Juan's murder.
The public always has been and always will be our greatest partner in fighting crime. In this case, they were very, very, very helpful.
Court documents also show that San Juan's ex-husband was with her when she gave Baker a ride on the weekend of July 13th. The ex-husband described Baker as being extremely agitated. Police say Baker and Mary Beth San Juan were acquaintances, but have not discussed how they first met. Baker is due back in court this Thursday.